हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय नेम इज़ सौरभ देशमुख, वर्किंग एज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग, वॉल्चन इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, सोलापुर. इन प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव लर्न द डायनेमिक विस्कोसिटी अलॉन्ग विद काइनेमेटिक विस्कोसिटी एंड देयर यूनिट्स. ऑल्सो वी हैव लर्न द न्यूटन्स लॉ ऑफ विस्कोसिटी. इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द इफेक्ट ऑफ टेम्परेचर ऑन विस्कोसिटी अलॉन्ग विद इट्स प्रॉब्लम्स. The learning outcome: at the end of this session, the learner will able to explain viscosity and will also able to solve problem on viscosity. Okay, now we will see the viscosity variation along with temperature. Okay, so effect of temperature on viscosity. So the temperature affects viscosity. Okay, the viscosity of liquid decreases with increase in temperature, while the viscosity of gases increases with increase in temperature. So I will write it here. The temperature viscosity for fluid for gas. Okay, so as the temperature of the fluid or the liquid decreases, the viscosity increases. Okay, and as the temperature of the gas decreases, the viscosity also decreases. Or in other term, as liquid and gas, as the temperature of the liquid or fluid increases, the viscosity decreases, and as the temperature of gas increases, the viscosity also increases. This happens because in liquid, the cohesive forces are dominant over the molecular transfer or molecular moment transfer. So as the temperature increases, the cohesive forces decreases, so the viscosity, we know that in liquid the cohesive forces are dominant over the molecular moment transfer. So as the temperature increases, the cohesive forces decreases, which cause the decrease in viscosity. But in gases, the cohesive forces are smaller as compared to the molecular moment transfer. So with increase in temperature, the molecular moment transfer increases, and hence the viscosity also increases. Okay, so for liquid, mu equals to mu zero into 1 upon 1 plus alpha t plus beta t square, where the mu is the viscosity of liquid at T degree Celsius. Okay, mu zero is viscosity of liquid at 0 degree Celsius. Alpha and beta are the constants for the liquid, where alpha equals to 0.03368 and beta equals to 0.000221. Okay, and the mu zero, that is the viscosity of the liquid or particularly water here, it is 1.79 × 10⁻³ poise. And for gases, the formula is mu equals to mu zero plus alpha t minus beta t square, where again mu is the viscosity of the gases at temperature T, mu zero is viscosity of gases at temperature zero, alpha and beta are constant, and T is temperature. Okay, for air, the value of mu zero equals to 0.000017, and alpha equals to, it is 0.00000056, while beta equals to, it is 0.11 8.9 into 10 raised to. Now we will see a problem on viscosity. So the problem, a plate 0.025 mm distant from a fixed plate moves at 60 cm per second and requires a force of 2 newton per unit area, that is 2 newton per meter square, to maintain the speed. Okay, now we need to determine the fluid viscosity between the plates. Now I will just draw a diagram here. Okay, this is the fixed plate and moving plate is at a 0.025 mm distance from the fixed plate. So this will be the moving plate, which is moving with the velocity 60 centimeter per second. Okay, and force is also required here to maintain the speed, which is 2 newton. Okay, and the distance between these two plates is, we take it as a dy equals to 0.025 mm. Let's consider these fluids are apart from each other by the means of oil. So now we need to calculate the viscosity of this oil. Okay, so first of all we will write the given data here. So they have given the distance between the plates. Okay, that is dy equals to 0.025 mm, which is equals to 0.025 into 10 raised to minus 3 meter. Also the velocity of the moving plate is also given, which is u equals to 60 centimeters per second. So it will be 0.6 meter per second. Also the force on the upper plate also is given, so that will be F equals to 2 newton per meter square. Now we need to calculate the viscosity of the oil. Okay, that will be mu equals to tau upon dou u by dou y. So we have the value of tau here, that is force required per unit area, that is tau, that is shear stress. We also have the value of dy. Now we need to calculate the du, that is the difference between the velocities of two plates. Obviously this plate is fixed, so the velocity of the fixed plate will be zero. So du equals to, it will be 60 minus 0, which is equals to 60 centimeter per second, that is 0.6 meter per second. So we will substitute this given data in this formula. So mu equals to tau is 2 upon du is 0.6 by 0.025 into 10 raised to minus 3. So after calculating this substitutions, we will get mu equals to 8.33 into 10 raised to minus 4 poise, or either 8.33 into 10 raised to minus 5 newton second per meter square. A flat plate of area 1.5 into 10 raised to 6 mm square is pulled with a speed of 0.4 meter per second. Okay, relative to another plate located at a distance of 0.15 mm apart from it. Find the force and power required to maintain the speed if the fluid separating them having viscosity 1 poise. Now we will write the given data here. So they have given the area of plate. So that will be A equals to 1.5 into 10 raised to 6 mm square, which is equals to 1.5 meter square. Now they have given the relative speed between the two plates. Okay, it is given as 0.4 meter per second. So it will be du equals to 0.4 meter per second. They have also given the relative distance between the two plates, that is 0.15 mm. So it will be dy equals to 0.15 mm, or it will be 0.15 into 10 raised to minus 3 meter. So now we need to calculate the force required and power required to maintain this speed. So we know that tau equals to mu into du by dy. So we will first calculate the tau, that is shear stress. So it will be also they have given the mu, okay, the value of viscosity. So mu equals to, it is 1 poise, or it is 1 by 10 newton second per meter square. So we will substitute it here, 1 by 10 into 0.4 upon 0.15 into 10 raised to minus 3. So it will be 266.66 newton per meter square. Now we need to calculate the force. Okay, so we all know that F equals to shear stress, or here tau, into area. Area of the plate is given here. So it will be 266.66 into the area is 1.5 meter square. So it will be 1.5. So the force required per unit area will be 400 newton. Now we need to calculate the power required to move this plate at a constant speed. So we all know that force into velocity, that is u here. Okay, so force will be here 400 into velocity is 0.4. So it will be 160 watt. So the power equals to 160 watt. And the force required to maintain the speed will be 400 newton. These are the references. Thank you.